You'd better wait here. Are you waiting?
The others have not arrived.
You will keep in the background, but the others must strike.
Mellow Hall at 2.
Yes, sir.
Thank you, lady. Thank you, lady.
Piper! Extra!
Paper, paper. Hello, all at 2. Give it out, lady, a copper. Mallow Hall at 2.
Hey, cabby. Mallow Hall at 2.
Remarkable, the strife
and
science is making these days.
Yes, I've heard of a new death ray. But this is called?
Baron Polinka and
Erlini. I am sorry we are so late.
Dr. Marshall.
It's quite all right, Baron. Gentlemen, the League of Nations has arranged this meeting for the purpose of demonstrating an invention which Sir James Blake assures us will end all wars. Sir James' retirement from Scotland Yard to assist in the perfection of this invention by his niece and Mr. Sheehan is characteristic of his efforts to promote peace among the peoples of the world. You turn the car around for our getaway to London.
Right.
To assist in this demonstration, the Admiralty has placed at Sir James' disposal an obsolete battleship. Be no lives sacrificed. The ship is radio controlled. This radio controlled ship, under the eyes of His Majesty's airmen, is cruising between 150 and 200 miles off Land's End. Mr. Sheehan has agreed to sight this ship in his visual finder and destroy it.
Why, it seems impossible. Incredible.
Well, Jerry, this is where we take over.
Will you explain the details as I work it?
Righto. Gentlemen, if you will watch this visual glass, you may observe the operation. The instrument first sends out a magnetic beam directed by a series of elevators. Under certain conditions, this beam becomes visual. The magnetic beam stops the progress of the target, as you will observe. Then within 10 seconds, the explosion follows.
Longitude, 6 degrees west. Latitude, 50, 30 north. It was a perfect hit. Ship sinking fast.
Longitude 6 degrees west. Latitude 50, 30 north. It was a perfect hit. The ship is sinking fast.
Correct.
Put me through to Mallow Hall.
Mallow Hall. Sir James speaking. To you, Admiral. Excuse me, Doctor.
Admiral Brandon speaking.
My dear, I'm as anxious as you and Jerry that it will work perfectly.
It still seems incredible. The observer reports that it was a perfect hit at 190 miles. The ship is sinking rapidly. This makes navies passe.
Standing armies will be a thing of the past.
Ammunition stocks will drop to nothing.
Uncle Jimmy, isn't it grand? I say, oh, Prune, that's showing them.
May I share?
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
Thank you indeed.
Very kind of you.
You make us the greatest nation in the world with this invention.
My uncle financed the perfection of this invention.
Only on the condition that it become the property of the League of Nations. And every country, great or small, shall feel safe to pursue its development unmolested.
We must dispose of our ammunition stock before the news becomes known. The bottom will fall out of our market.
That little machine will do away with our organization.
Doubtless you appreciate the necessity for every precaution.
I've warned Sir James, his life will pay if this news reaches the wrong quarters.
Gentlemen, I've taken means to that end.
It was a magnificent demonstration.
Thank you, Baron. Good afternoon, sir.
No.
No wars, no espionage.
Uncle Jimmy?
Yes?
We're sure we can dish it out, eh?
Dish it out? What does that mean in proper English?
Well, Jerry says that's American slang for blasting them out of your way.
I shall have to talk to Jerry. I'm afraid he's corrupting your English.
Got Basil and the Scorpion will make a fortune out of ammunition stocks when we secure that invention.
Yeah, but our job is to secure the invention.
The Scorpion. Again, eh? Count Basil. We mustn't forget those names, Bobby.
The telephone. Scorpion.
You must secure that invention tonight.
Yes, sir.
Thank you.
You must secure Blake's invention at once. Come along.
No, no. I feel quite sure that none of the family know that we built this company.
Quiet, Jerry. We have some prowlers below after your invasion.
Sir James will not permit harm to come to the children. I've got to stay in the background. Remember, second and third door.
James, we entertain no thoughts of defeat in this project. You will turn that invention over to us intact. Or...
No, Uncle Jimmy! No! Don't, Uncle!
You leave me no alternative. Leave him here.
I advise you not to follow.
Yes, Inspector Henderson. Count Basil Segaloff was in London only a few hours. He has returned to Paris.
Positive about that, Dickens? Right. Segaloff flew to Paris this afternoon.
And the Scorpion won't be far behind him.
And I take it that you will not be far behind the Scorpion.
Right you are, Henderson.
Mind if I join you?
Mind. I'd appreciate it no end.
Pick me up at the Yard.
Right. If I ask you to remain here, Hope, you'll revolt.
Quite right. And you're going to find something for me to do.
Right you are. You also, Jerry.
Thanks.
Perhaps I can be of some assistance.
Well, that's splendid, Doctor.
What am I going to do, Uncle Jimmy?
Oh, wait. We'll be leaving shortly. We'd better go and dress.
Right.
Now, Bobby, I have a very important assignment for you. This is
very, very important. I want you to stay here and keep a close watch on Charles.
Charles? I've always suspected him.
Pretty shoulders, my petite. Should you ever try to leave me again?
Keep an eye open for Mimi. I'm going to check up on those children.
Quiet.
Just so, honey, just a minute. One more for my little woman.
There doesn't seem to be any
energy. Children are doing very nicely.
What's the matter with my wife? Always wanting me. I don't want you to dance with me. Apache.
Oh, nah. You're just plebeian. Look at these Fraser Apaches. They're wonderful dancers.
Oh, boy.
These Americans from the provinces certainly have a limited capacity.
Practically none.
I received your instructions, Sir James. Everything is as you requested.
Thank you. Doctor, I wish you'd remain here. I don't want you involved in this.
That's the way you feel, Jimmy. But I want to be helpful.
Thank you, Doctor. I'd rather you'd remain. Henderson, give us about 4 minutes.
Right, Jimmy. Come along, Mimi.
Quiet, Doctor. You remain here, Doctor.
What's the matter, huh?
What do you make of that?
I don't understand.
You wait in the room above,
and I'll check on the roof.
I'd like to see that note.
So would I.
Keep order here, Pierre. I'll be back shortly.
Wait, wait. I think I can do it.
Now, I'd like to oblige you, lady, but you say I'm urgent business and later, please.
Oh, come on, big fella.
No, later.
You won't let me down the house.
Well,
come on,
I won't let you down, but later,
you, Mr. Ezra Hopkins?
Why, sure.
I met you in Sheffield.
Oh, Sheffield, sure, sir. You know the wife, Mr. Sheffield. Sit down.
Yeah.
Gargon! Oh, Mr. Sheffield.
We ought to get up there. He may need us. Jimmy knows what he's about. A false move of ours might wreck his plan.
Perhaps you're right. This waiting makes me goose-pimply all over.
Lake.
Jimmy. Get him below if his neck's not broken.
What's happened to Jimmy? Follow me when I get up. Keep up the byplay.
Now, wait a minute. You can't walk out on our honeymoon like this.
Why wasn't you
hear that to me? Come back here. Now, listen to me like.
Dr. Marshall. What's happened? What are you doing here?
Oh, I was following Baron Polinka. He attacked me.
Well, have you seen Count Basil?
No. Was he here?
Well, I was following him when I found you. Come along. I'll get you out of here. Come on.
Pardon, monsieur. It is not permitted to go this way.
Oh, it's all right, Marco. It's all right. We're a perfectly respectable married couple, and this is our chaperone.
Oh, Henderson should be waiting for us in the cafe.
So sorry. Jimmy, Dr. Marshall.
Uncle Jimmy.
Oh,
friends of yours? Well, I'll buy them a drink. Sit down, gentlemen.
I'll have to go back to my hotel.
By all means, Doctor. Jerry will put you in a cab.
Let me help, Doctor.
One moment, please. Jim. Inspector. I'm no detective.
Thank you, Doctor. You may be right. We'll keep an eye on the Baron.
If Baron Polinka is in Paris, as Marshall says, he may be within reaching distance of the Scorpion.
Marshall is very shrewd. His guess may be as good as yours, or mine. I'm going to have another look for Segalov. Wait here for me. When those youngsters get back, tell Jerry to take Hope to the hotel.
Right. Now, here is the street, and this is the room occupied by Count Basil.
We understand, Inspector. We're to get what information we can, and...
And that's all. And no unnecessary risks.
We'll be careful, Uncle Jimmy.
I hope so.
Don't worry about us, Jimmy. We'll be all right.
Well, goodbye, and good luck.
Thank you. Come along, Mrs. Sheehan.
And now for our part of the job, Inspector.
Shall we try this one?
All right.
That's my son. John's a gentle lad, but he's not quite right in the head. What could I be doing for you?
Oh, my husband and I are looking for
a... Yeah, we're looking for a room. We saw your sign.
Oh. Well, I have nothing vacant but a front room and the floor above.
Well, that's what we're looking for, eh, darling?
Oh, well. This way. Right here. Here you are.
I don't think I care for this.
Well, we'll take it for a week anyway.
Let's see. Anything I can do for you?
No, thank you. Just leave us alone. We'll get settled. Right?
Thanks, Jeff. Bye, Jeff. What a break. The room right above Basil's. I'll lock the door.
Let's get to work.
The room upstairs. I let it this morning. To whom? Sheehan and the girl. I recognized them from the photographs.
Are they alone?
Yes. I thought it best to let them think we suspected nothing.
You did well. I'll take care of this. You're all here.
Scorpion just came in.
Good. I have orders for all of you.
Give me 5 minutes, boys.
Right, Jimmy.
You won't get hurt. Is anybody here?
Only my son, Jackie. In that ain't quite right in the head.
Okay.
Yeah, well, what are you doing? Shut up. Obviously. No.
Shut up. Come in, man. All's clear. Go to the room above. Jerry knows it. And get that dictaphone working. I'll take care of this end.
Right.
And we're going up, too. Come along, step lively. Here. You remain quiet and you won't get hurt. You understand?
No matter what happens here tonight, you're deaf, dumb, and blind. That way you'll keep out of trouble. You understand?
Right, old governor.
Carry on.
You got a knife?
Can you see them?
I can only see their shadows.
Watching. I'm going below to check up on the old man.
All right.
What's the matter with you?
Come on, what are we waiting for? Let's rush.
Shh.
He'll attack as soon as Peyton returns. And when they're all in the room, then we'll have the entire gang.
Thank you.
look like you'd done for the other one.
Well, I can't say that I'm sorry. I'm going to have a look for Jimmy.
The other one, what became of him?
Jerry did away with him in the water.
And Daggett?
He's still loose.
I see. What became of Nicky?
Like Daggett took it on the lamb.
On the what?
Skip it, Skipper. He amscrayed.
I don't agree with you. I believe he ran away.
Let's adjourn to the hall. This argument's wearing me out.
Yes. Yes. Very good, Dickens. They picked up Segalov's trail. He's in London again.
Sooner or later, he'll lead us to the hiding place of the Scorpion. The finding of Baron Polinka's body in that Paris dive narrows our search down considerably.
Come on now, me hearty, or I'll be working on you again.
What have you got there, Briggs?
I found him trying to get out of the underground passage with this. He got rough, so I had to maul him a bit, sir.
Oh, yes, yes, of course. One of the queer gentry who raided us the other night.
Very good, Briggs. We'll take care of him.
Thank you, sir.
I have a few questions to ask you, my friend. And the right answers may help you when you come to trial.
Well, I ain't talking.
Take your choice, my man. Whether you talk or not, I have evidence enough to lock you up for a long term.
I've told you all I can. I don't know any names. We've all got numbers. Scorpion is number one. None of us have ever seen him without his mask.
How are you called to a meeting?
An old woman in Limehouse. She's number seven and knows where to find us.
I think I know the lady. Henderson, do you mind calling the yard? It might be worthwhile to check up on number seven.
Tell Count Basil to join me at once in the usual place. I have secured what he is waiting for. the police infallible? Tell him to come with the passage. He'll be safe.
Principals are impatient with the delay.
You were already with the cash?
I have already explained that I will give you unquestioned guarantees and signatures. Is that the instrument?
Those signatures again, and I will demonstrate the ray. Sir James Blair.
No, my friend, I'm
come here. Come here. Henderson. Get him, man. Hold it. Come on. The talk is in here.
This is the one exit we didn't have covered, Henderson. And we've lost him. But not for long. Let me show you something. The bait for our trap, Henderson.
Thank you. Could I be of any help to you?
Keep back. I'll shoot the first man to move. Well, my friend, it seems we've come to the end of the trail. Dr. Marshall, the Scorpion.
You! Goodness.
Dr. Marshall, you've reached the end of the road. And gentlemen of the League of Nations, in behalf of my young friends and myself, I wish to acknowledge the honor that you have seen fit to bestow upon us, and to express the belief that in accepting the death ray, you have made a long stride toward the preservation of the peace of the world.
Since the war is over. You try to forget you're an inventor in a gun mall and just be a...
A what, Jerry?
Well, let's call it a girlfriend.
Amscray, Uncle Jimmy. Amscray.
I beg your pardon. What does that mean in proper English?
Amscray, Uncle Jimmy? Why, it's slang for scram.
Scram. Yes, of course. Come here, young man. I want to talk to you.